overseas players entering India, it's actually a new world, right? So they may have the muscle of size and scale and distribution, but they still have to figure out the market, because it's not like they can bring something that worked in another part of the world into India, right? So that is the big difference between this sector and, say, what happened in the e-commerce sector, where Amazon effectively brought something that was already working, and you know, the local players had to innovate more and more, and Amazon, you know, has, of course, you know, shown that it can innovate as well. So the big players have a track record of innovation, but they will have to do the innovation afresh in India. So to me, I have never understood the difference between a wallet and a bank account, right? I think ultimately they're a store of somebody's money, other people's money, and has to be done in a responsible manner. And I think what's happening now is we're starting to see uniform rules being applied. It doesn't matter whether it's a wallet or a bank account or a prepaid instrument or a credit card or a credit instrument. You need to do full KYC because, you know, the technology has made KYC really inexpensive and ubiquitous, right? So there were few reasons in the past why they were sort of given this, you know, honeymoon period where they didn't need to do such stringent KYC was because it was very expensive to do it. But today, you know, as Jio has shown with Aadhaar eKYC or, you know, with biometrics, you can do a KYC at under, you know, maybe 25 rupees. Whereas in the past, KYC used to be 500 rupees, right, to onboard a customer. So with that in mind, you know, I think it's, you know, it's reasonable to expect that all accounts should have, you know, equal KYC because it is effectively free and ubiquitous, right? So I think broadly, if you see all these guidelines, either these are new guidelines in areas that did not exist, or they are relaxing the guidelines to, you know, to make it easier to do business, right? I don't think you'll find guidelines in an area which was were already there that are now being constrained. It is not that often, right? I think broadly, what we are finding and what I've seen from the finance ministry is the desire to make financial services pervasive and more inclusive, right? Whether it is for SMEs, whether it is for consumers, whether it's for bottom of the pyramid, whether it is what have you, there is, I don't think there has been a single circle in the past that has said, stop what you're doing and let's, you know, restrict people from doing it, right? What I would like to see, however, in addition is a sandbox approach, right? So I think the regulations going forward are fine, but in certain areas, you know, we do need to do some controlled experiments, right? So broadly, you know, the fund is, you know, 400 crore, $60 million. And we will be working in three broad areas, financial services, enterprise and SaaS solutions, as well as in healthcare. Within financial services, we look at, of course, you know, at the macro level, you know, payments, lending, and you know, insurance and wealth management. These are sort of the four broad areas. But in each of these areas, we look at solutions that target a large enough group of customers and are fairly differentiated, right? So we generally don't do you know, any copycats in our fund. We've always been the first investor in the new concept, always. Where I see opportunities, I see with the digitization, there are several vertical solutions that can emerge. And I would say Happy and Neo and Credex are examples, or a Fortplan are, you know, really examples of, you know, vertical focused financial services. I will expect to see several more of those happening. So we invested in 19 companies over the life of these three funds. You know, one exited, which is Ziptile. One didn't do very well early on, and that got shut down. And all the other companies are actually doing very well and thriving. We, of course, will be opportunistic, you know, if an opportunity arises and, you know, the entrepreneurs want to do this and, you know, want to exit and it's the right thing for the company. But as investors and our own investors who are our limited partners, you know, we are, you know, very long-term focused. We think India is going to be a long-term play, but it's going to be a huge play. And we want to be invested in the right companies so that we can, you know, get the best returns over a period of time. We're really focused on building these big companies.